Amen. What a friend we have in Jesus. Amen.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. And what a privilege to care.
Trials.
Have we trials and temptations? Well, is there trouble anywhere? And we take it to the Lord in prayer. And can we find a friend so faithful? And who will all our sorrows share? Oh, Jesus knows our every weakness, so take it to the Lord in prayer. And are we weak and heavy laden and cumbered with a load of care?
Precious Savior,
oh precious Savior, still our refuge, just take it to the Lord in prayer. And do thy friends despise, forsake thee? Oh, take it to the Lord in prayer. And in his arms he'll take and shield thee. Oh, thou wilt find a solace there.
Amen. How many want to be taken in and shielded by our precious Savior? Amen. How many are happy about that privilege, are thankful for that privilege he's given to us? Amen. Let's just bow our heads this evening as we open up our service tonight. Oh, Father God, Lord, we want to thank you, Father God, that despite our unworthiness, Father, you've still offered us the privilege, Lord God. You've offered us a pardon, Lord. Help us tonight to continue to accept that pardon, Father God, that way we might be free of guilt, free of condemnation, Father God, that we might worship you, Lord, and be drawn closer to you yet still, Father God. Lord, we ask these things, Lord, that you'd be invited, Father God, and welcome to walk up and down these aisles, Father God, in this house of praise tonight, Lord. We ask these things in your wonderful, precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. You may be seated tonight, church. Amen. Let's sing that. 47 in our key, in the key of C. I know whom I've believed. Amen. I know not why God's wondrous grace to me he hath made known, nor why unworthy Christ in love redeemed me for his own. Oh, but I know whom I have believed, and am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I've committed unto him against that day. I know not how this saving faith to me within my heart, but I know whom and am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I've committed unto him against that day. I know not how the Spirit moves, convincing men of sin, revealing Jesus through the Word, creating faith in him. Oh, but I know and am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I've committed, oh, unto him against that day. I know not what of good or ill may be for me, of weary ways or golden days before his face I see. But I know whom I have believed in and am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I've committed unto him against that day. And I know not when my Lord may come at night or noonday fair, nor if I'll walk the veil with him or meet him in the air. Oh, but I know whom I have believed in and am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I've committed, oh, unto him against that day. Give him praise tonight, church, as our brother comes. Amen. Is he able? Amen. How many are happy that he's persuaded you that he is able? Amen. Let's bow our heads tonight. Father God, Lord, it is such a privilege, Lord, to be in this house of praise, Father God, to be able to invite your Spirit, Lord, to sing these praises, Father God, and to know, Lord, that we're singing truth, Father God. What we're singing about is life, and it's daily rejoicing, Father God, that we're able to sing these hymns, these beautiful hymns, we just pray that they are a sweet incense to you, Father God, a sweet sound in your ear. Lord, we just ask that you would bless those who give back to your kingdom, Father God, for the furtherment of your ministry, Lord. It's a privilege to be a part of the economy of God. In your precious name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. I'm following Jesus each step of the way. Before we take our needs to him tonight, I'm following Jesus one step at a time. I live for the moment in his love divine. Why think of tomorrow? Today, I'm following Jesus each step of the way. The pathway is narrow, but he leads me on. I walk in his shadow, my fears are all gone. My spirit grows stronger each moment, each day, for Jesus is step of the way. I'm following Jesus. I'm following Jesus one step at a time. I want for the moment in his love divine. Why think of tomorrow? Just live for today. I'm following Jesus each step of the way. Amen. How many thankful are being a following of our Jesus Christ tonight? Amen. In this late hour, he still has a group. Amen. A little bride waiting. Amen. Well, we have several written requests here this evening. Please remember my niece, Shannon, in prayer. She's in the hospital with sepsis blood infection, with a sepsis blood infection after having surgery. Also for a neighbor's brother, he asked me if our church could pray for his brother who is experiencing some mental imbalances. Thank you from a brother Fred. Brothers and sisters, please keep my Aunt Gloria in prayer for a healing touch. Thank you from my sister Annette. God bless you. Please remember brother Patrick and sister Judy in prayer. He is not feeling well and needs strength and a touch from our Lord. Amen. And God bless you. Please remember my cousin, brother Ernie Hernice in prayer, needing the Lord's comfort and encouragement in the Spirit. May the Lord minister a special blessing and need unto him, brother, from our brother Ralph. Amen. Well, we've read these needs. Let's go before the author. Let's stand tonight. Let any unspoken request be made known by the raising of our hands this evening as we bow our heads, amen, and close our eyes. Oh, Lord, Father God, we're a needy people this evening, Father God. Lord, we've read these prayer requests, Lord. We want to lift them up to you now, Father God. Lord, for those who are in need of a healing of their body, Father God, their need of strength, Lord, we just ask, Lord, for you to meet them in their need, Father God. For our brother Patrick, Lord, and our sister Judy, Father God, and for our sister Annette's Aunt Gloria, Father God, those who are in need of this touch in their body, Lord, we just ask that you'll be with them, Father God. For our brother Ernie Hernice, Lord, who's in need of comfort and encouragement in his spirit, Father God. We just ask that, Lord, you'll minister unto him. Minister under his spirit, Lord. Use your little lights, Father God, as servants for your will, Father God. And Lord, let us just surrender ourselves more unto you, Father God, that you might use us better, Lord. And for our brother Fred's niece Sharon, Lord, who's in the hospital with this infection, Father God, we rebuke this infection, Lord. Father God, she may have gotten it from a surgery, Lord, Father God, but we know that you have the power to heal, Father God. And we're turning over the situation to you, Lord and God, and we thank you in advance, Lord, for what you do for this one. And for our brother Fred's neighbor, Lord, who's in need for his brother, Father God, who's experiencing some mental imbalances, Lord, Father God, we just ask that you would be with them and comfort them, Father God, and help straighten things out for them, Father God, that you might bring him relief in his life, Father God. And may it be a testimony of your grace and of your mercy, O Lord, Father. And for any unspoken requests your children have made known by the raising of their hands tonight, Father God, be with them in their time of need, Lord. You know what that need is, Father God, and you know what's on the heart of that individual, Father God. We just ask that you'll be the compassionate God that we know that you are, Father God, and meet the needs of your children tonight, Father. Be with our pastor, Lord. Use him as your mouthpiece, Father God. Prepare him as he's ready to come tonight, Father God. Let something be said, amen, for your kingdom, for your glory, Father God, as that's all we're here for, Father God, to keep you at the center of our lives. We thank you and praise you, Father God. In your name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. You may be seated tonight, church. As we bring our pastor on this evening, let's sing that beautiful little chorus, "Oh, What a Miracle." Pastor comes.
Amen. Yes. It's a miracle, isn't it? Praise the Lord. Aren't you so grateful for that? So thankful in your heart. Amen. That's the greatest miracle that God can do. When he transforms a life, when he changes a life, amen, to a life of Christ, a life of Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless you this evening. Good to be in the house of the Lord. I see we have some guests here with us, and we just welcome you. Thank you for coming. This would be your family, right, sisters? Stephanie? Your mom and your sister. Hi. Yes. That's good to have you in service. Yes, your little nieces there. That's good. God bless you. Amen. God bless you, saints. We want to turn here to Revelation, the sixth chapter. Revelation chapter 6 and verse 12. We'd stand for the reading of the word. Verse 12. And I beheld when he had opened the sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood, and the stars of heaven fell unto the earth, even as a fig tree casteth her untimely figs when she is shaken of a mighty wind. And the heaven departed as a scroll when it is rolled together, and every mountain and island were moved out of their places. And the kings of the earth and the great men and the rich men and the chief captains and the mighty men and every bondman and every free man hid themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains and said to the mountains and rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb. For the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand? Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this opportunity to come to your house again. And Lord, we thank you for your word. Father, that we can open the scriptures, Lord, but it takes the Holy Spirit to discern, Lord, what is inside the book, the Bible. It takes revelation. And you only give revelation. You give divine, supernatural revelation to your elect, to your sheep, to your people that you have redeemed by your blood. Father, I pray that the spirit of revelation would be upon us now as we go into your word and speak of the hour that we're living in and what is coming upon the earth and what it means and how we can prepare for these great events that are right before us. May you help us and be with us, be with the people that are viewing this service in their homes or online, wherever they're at. May you bless them, minister to their needs, Lord. Answer their requests, Lord. If they're sick, Give them faith to receive healing for their bodies, Lord, that they might be healthy and prosper in their souls and in their physical bodies, Lord, that they might be able to serve you better, wholeheartedly, Lord, and joyfully. So, Father, we commit ourselves to you in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. And God's people said, amen. You may be seated. I want to title the little talk this morning. This morning, that's not morning, is it? I'm thinking it's Sunday morning. Yeah. I want to title it Interruption. In the interruption. And so we can see what this sixth seal, the sixth seal is when he had opened the sixth seal. It's an interruption of nature, isn't it? It's nature, God's creation. The sun, the stars, the moon, the earth, everything that God created is going through an interruption. It's going through it's going through birth pains. And it's the sixth seal that is opened with an earthquake. And when he had opened the sixth seal, there was an earthquake, a mighty earthquake. So we know what that earthquake is. We know that the prophet, made it known that that's the California earthquake. And that will open the sixth seal. So the sixth seal is opened with the California earthquake. So, you know, the scientists predict a great earthquake, a great catastrophe. Of course, they don't really know the magnitude, but the prophet of God told us how powerful that earthquake would be and what it would do, just exactly what that earthquake would cause. It would just cause a breaking off of a landmass of California. And so that's the opening of the sixth seal. So it opens with an earthquake, and then the Bible tells us that the sun becomes black and the moon becomes as blood. So now, why does this happen? Well, this happens because the Lamb has left his mediatorial work. There's no more blood on the mercy seat of God. God has come for his church, and she's fixing to go into a rapture. And there's no more Gentiles saved in the tribulation period. Because the sixth seal and the moon turning to blood and the sun becoming sackcloth, tribulation follows that, the great tribulation. You've all heard of the great tribulation. The whole world, the whole church world has heard that there's coming a great tribulation, and many are divided as to what will happen to the true church at that time. Will she have to go through the tribulation, or will she be raptured out of it so that she doesn't have to go through the tribulation? And so we know by what Brother Branham has told us, our prophet, that the bride does not go through the tribulation. The 3.5 years of absolute horror and catastrophe that befalls the earth for 3.5 years. And that's the great tribulation. And now, so that's a terrible time. It's a terrible time for the world, for the unbelievers, for the rejecters of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And now when the church or the bride, which is his elect church, his people, when they leave, go in the rapture to meet Jesus in the heavens, here on earth there is a total interruption of nature. And all nature has been having birth pains. It's been having birth pains all these years, many, many hundreds and thousands of years. The earth has been having birth pains, and the intensity of those birth pains is getting greater and greater. That's why we hear of earthquakes all the time. And the earthquakes are all over the world, not just in California, but all over the United States and all over the different countries, India and Europe, and all over. The earth is, because the earth contains the bodies of God's people. God's people that have died, have gone on, their bodies are laying in the dust of the earth. And so the earth is crying out in pain to be delivered, see? So it's a complete interruption of nature. That is what is happening. That's why we see all the hurricanes and tornadoes and disasters and famines and killings and mass killings and wars, terrible wars that are happening. So it's because this is the day of man. This is the day of man. But now what we read here in the sixth seal, that's opening the day of the Lord. The day of the Lord. The day of man, he rules it and he reigns. Now, I want to read here in Romans, the 8th chapter, to back up what I just said about the whole earth is groaning and why all these different catastrophes and events that are taking place now under the sixth seal. Now, if we read here, if you turn with me, I want you to catch this here in Romans, the 8th chapter, and Romans 8 and verse 18, and read it with me here. Read it with me, because I want this to just stick with you good. Okay, you got it? Romans 8, 18. Here we go. Together. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. Amen. So whatever you're suffering, you know, whatever you're going through, whatever is happening in your life, the conflicts, sorrow, sickness, temptations, trials, whatever is happening in your life, that's not to be compared. It's not worthy to be compared with the glory that God's going to reveal through you. It's not worthy to be compared with the glory, the exaltation that's going to be manifested through the children of God. Now, so the Bible tells us here, the glory which shall be revealed in us. Verse 19, let's read verse 19 together. For the earnest expectation of the creature waiteth for the manifestation of the sons of God. So the creation then is waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God, God's children, God's people. Verse 20, let's read it. For the creature was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who hath subjected the same in hope. So that word creature there, that means creation. Creation, that means creation. Creature means creation. The creation, for the creation was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who hath subjected the same in hope. When Adam and Eve sinned, they were cast out of the Garden of Eden, and when man fell, the earth fell also. The earth fell also, and man lost his domain. he lost his godship over the earth because he was an amateur god over the earth. And so he lost that, and he was taken out of the presence of God. And so now the earth has been subject to sin also. So that's what the scripture is saying here. For the creature or the creation was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who hath subjected the same in hope, because the earth was lost, but not without hope. Just like we were lost, but not without hope. Because God had provided a lamb called Jesus Christ, who was slain in the mind of God before the foundation of the world. Amen. And he put our names on that Lamb's Book of Life when he was redeemed, when he was slain, when Jesus was slain at Calvary. We were identified with his crucifixion, and we were put on the Lamb's Book of Life before the foundation of the world. Amen. So then now let's go to verse 21. For because the creation or the creature itself, which means creation, okay? Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption. See, the creation, it's going to be delivered from the bondage of corruption in the glorious liberty of the children of God. See? For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together until now. So the creation is groaning, travailing. That's these earthquakes. The earth is groaning, and all nature, man doesn't control it. See? So now, and not only they, verse 23, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we ourselves groan within ourselves. So when God gives you the Holy Spirit, it causes you to groan. It causes you, in other words, to hunger more for God. It's the deep calling to the deep. It's a deep calling to the deep God. See, you're hungering because there's a God out there that made you that way, to hunger for him. God made us to hunger and to thirst for him. So now, without him, we can't do anything. So we need his Holy Spirit in us to cause us to groan. And we cry, Abba, Father, oh, my God, oh, my Father. You know, and so that hunger, that thirst, God put that there. Now, a lot of people don't recognize what that hunger is, what that thirst is, because they've been filling it with so many other things. They fill it with the things of the world. They fill it with Satan's world, Satan's kingdom, the love of the world, the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, and the sin and the immorality, because we're in a fallen state. Man is in a fallen state. So Jesus came to redeem us from that fallen state. And so now when he gives us the new birth, he gives us the baptism of the Holy Spirit. That's the first fruits. First fruits means that there's more to come. The more to come. So the more you hunger, the more God gives you. The more you thirst and the more you cry out for God, the more he reveals himself to you. He opens up the scriptures to you. He leads you and he guides you because he's the chief shepherd. He's the shepherd of your life. See, he's God's shepherd. The Holy Spirit is the shepherd that leads us and guides us to all truth. And God also uses prophets, servants, ministers that he raises, that he sends. And Jesus said, he that receives you receives me, and he that doesn't receive you rejects me. And he that receives you receives me and receives him that sent me. Amen. Is that right? Now, so then, we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting. Why do we groan? Why do we groan in the Spirit? Because God has given us his Spirit to groan. To groan. And what does that, what are we calling for? We're calling for something. Now, this is what the Bible says. Even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption, to wit, the redemption of our body. In other words, the body change, a new body, a body like Jesus. So that's why we groan. For the adoption, the full adoption comes at the body change. Amen. When we get a body change like his own glorious body. Is that right? Because we can't meet Jesus in the heavens with these old bodies. We can't meet Jesus in the heavens. We got to have a body change like his own body in order to meet Jesus in the heavens. Because we meet him. We meet him in the air. Is that right? Amen. But we got to have a body change. So that's why the scripture is telling us. That's why we groan. We groan. God gave us the Holy Spirit so we could groan for that body, that tabernacle, see? So we groan in that, in this body, because this body's not right. This body's still in sin. This body is came through a natural process, a sexual birth, and so therefore it's a body of corruption, see? And so it's decaying, it's dying, it's corrupting, corrupting, and it'll go back to the grave. This body will. But see, we have a glorious body in heaven. Amen. If this tabernacle be dissolved, the Bible says, we have one already in the heavens, not made with hands of man. See, eternal in the heavens. God made that body. Amen. So we're groaning for that body. We're groaning for body, that body. But you can't groan for that body until you get the first fruits of the Holy Spirit. Notice in verse 23 how the Spirit is with a capital S. Is that right? Capital S. That means it's God's Holy Spirit. And that causes us to groan in the Spirit. Now, so then, as we said, getting back to this opening of this sixth seal, because it's all tied in with what I just said, that there's, during this time, there's no more Gentiles saved in the tribulation time. There's no more salvation during the tribulation. Salvation is right now. Now is the time to repent and get right with God and obey his gospel, which is Acts 2:38. Repent and repent and be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. For the remission of your sins. The name of Jesus Christ remits sin. It has to be the name of Jesus Christ, not Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Those are titles. Those are titles to a name. Father, Son, Holy Ghost are titles to the name Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So then that's the name above all names. There's no other name given unto men whereby we may be saved. So that's the name of our redemption. See? And so then salvation is, now is the day of salvation, because during that time there will be none. Only for the 144,000, the Jews that are called during that time. Now, then, again, this sixth seal is a total interruption of nature. All nature, as we said, has been having these birth pains. And here, under the sixth seal, she's let loose. And the people on earth are in total chaos. The people that are left behind, because the sixth seal is the judgment seal of the Word. The sixth seal, now you might want to write some of these things down. The sixth seal is the judgment seal of the Word. So the Word of God is going to judge the world. Is that right? God's Word is going to judge the world. Now, so remember the threefold purpose of the sixth seal. What was the threefold purpose? First, to purge the earth for the millennium. We purge the earth for the millennium. And number two, to call out the 144,000 by the two witnesses. And number three, to purge the foolish virgin that did not go in the rapture. The saved church, the church that's saved, but she's not the elect bride of Jesus Christ, but she is the church that's saved. But she'll have to go through the tribulation for her salvation. And the reason why is because she didn't have oil in her lamp. Remember, there was 10 virgins. 5 were wise and 5 were foolish, and the 5 had oil and the 5 that didn't. The 5 that had the oil, that means they had the Holy Spirit. They were the ones that went in the rapture. And the 5 that didn't have the Holy Spirit, didn't have oil in their lamps, they had to go through tribulation. When they knocked at the door, it was closed. The door was closed, and they had to go pray, and they were left outside where there's weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth. That's that foolish virgin, that church. She failed to get the revelation of Jesus Christ and to be filled with the Spirit, God's Spirit, to cause her to groan, to cause her to travail, see, for that adoption, for that body change, for that new body, that heavenly glorious body, like his own body, Jesus' body. So then, this sixth seal, then, it's this foolish virgin, she has to be redeemed under the sixth seal. It's a judgment seal for the foolish virgin. And, of course, being that the sixth seal is a judgment seal of the Word, the wise virgin, that's you and I, we pray. We hope. We believe. Yeah. The wise virgin that has the revelation, that has that oil, that has the first fruits of the Spirit. See? We also come under that sixth seal of judgment. Because where does judgment begin? It begins in the house of God. That's where judgment begins, with you and me. We have to judge ourselves. Don't judge our neighbor. Don't judge someone else. Do not judge them. Judge yourself. Judge myself. Look at myself. Don't look at somebody else. Amen. And then say you have an excuse to stumble or to do something. Well, look what they're doing. See, no, you're not going to answer for them. You're going to answer for yourself. We're going to answer for ourselves. Yes. So then again, it's a judgment. It's a judgment. It's a judgment for everybody. But now, the church, the bride, the elect, as I said, we are receiving our judgment now. But we don't have to be judged at the white throne judgment. So we don't have to be judged in the great tribulation. There's no judgment. See? Because we're receiving our judgment now. Our judgment is by obeying the Word of God. By obeying Christ, by loving Christ, keeping his commandments, and being filled with the Spirit. Being filled with the Spirit and catching that revelation of the Son of Man in this hour. The revelation of the Son of Man, which is Jesus Christ. Remember, the foolish virgin didn't have that revelation. But the wise virgin has it. She's wise because she gets that revelation. See, she has that revelation. And so now, it's going to be a terrifying time according to the scriptures, see? And it's going to be for 3.5 years of hell on earth. The man will seek death, but he won't be able to find it because the plagues are going to be poured out during that time. And so to get a better, clearer glimpse of this event, let's go to Isaiah chapter 13. And this was prophesied. Isaiah prophesied of this 2,700 years ago. So we go to the book of Isaiah here, and chapter 13, and we begin reading here with verse 6. Here it is. So here's what Isaiah saw. The prophet Isaiah saw this 2,700 years ago. Over 2,700 years ago. He's prophesying this here of the sixth seal. Let's read it together. Howl ye for the day of the Lord. Stop right there. The day of the Lord is at hand. This is the day of man. This is man's day. Man's ideas, man's church, man's program, man's plans. It's man's world. Man, he controls, he governs. The day of man, this is man's day. But the day of the Lord is coming. The day of the Lord. Now, so what happens? The day of the Lord interrupts the day of man. The day of the Lord interrupts. That sixth seal is an interruption of nature. And it interrupts the day of man. So now, howl ye, for the day of the Lord is at hand. It shall come as a destruction from the Almighty. Therefore shall all hands be faint, and every man's heart shall melt, and they shall be afraid. Pangs and sorrows shall take hold of them. They shall be in pain as a woman that travaileth. They shall be amazed one at another. Their faces shall be as flames. Behold, the day of the Lord cometh, cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, to lay the land desolate, and he shall destroy the sinners therefore out of it. So now, what's verse 10 say? Verse 10? Let's read it together. Here's your sixth seal. Here's your sixth seal. For the stars of heaven and the constellations thereof shall not give their light. They're not going to give their light. Now, the sun shall be darkened in the going forth, and the moon shall not cause her light to shine. Verse 11, let's read it. And I will punish the world for their evil and the wicked for their iniquity. And I will cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease and will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible. So this is the day of man again. He rules the earth, and he has his way with his scientific knowledge of the tree of good and evil and his scientific achievements. And that's why we have wars and we have famine. We have men killing one another because it's man's day. But this here is the day of the Lord. When the judgment that was proclaimed in Revelation 1, one likened to the Son of Man, He had the wig over his head. His eyes were a flame of fire, and he's got the clothing of a judge. And he's coming to judge. He's proclaiming judgment. He's been proclaiming it there in Revelations 1. That's Christ. That's Christ, Jesus Christ, in Revelations 1. And he's there, and he's got the white wig, and he is the judge. He's proclaiming judgment so that we can hear what God has to say and how we must be ready and ready for that great day so that we don't have to go through the tribulation. Because we know that it's a judgment coming upon the world, we don't want to miss that rapture. We want to make that rapture. Now, we want to meet the Lord Jesus in the skies. So this one there in Revelations 1, he's dressed like a judge, and he's fulfilling, or he's proclaiming the judgment. That's under the sixth seal. Revelations 1 is under the sixth seal of judgment. Right now, see, God has been proclaiming these judgments through the prophets, through the ministers, through the preachers, through the evangelists, and through different ministries and gifts of the Spirit. The day of judgment is coming. Man knows it. All man talks about now is World War III. You hear it all the time, that the world is heading for an Armageddon. There's no way out of it. The world is heading for a World War III. And that's going to just annihilate everything. That's at the end of the 3.5 years. But now the bride is not here. She goes up. She's living in heaven with her husband, Jesus Christ, the bridegroom. The bridegroom, our bridegroom. We are his bride. He is the bridegroom. So then these judgments, they soon will happen. They will become a reality to the lost world, to those that have rejected Christ, to those that have mocked Christ, to those that have blasphemed God, blasphemed his name, to those that have persecuted the people of God. Now the world will be left behind to suffer those judgments, to die. And the Bible says it'll be so bad that man will seek death in those days, but will not find it. Death will escape them because hell will be right here on the earth. So it's going to be a terrible time. See, and we as the elect of God, we know this because we have believed this message. We have believed Christ. We have believed the Word. And we are his sheep. And my sheep hear my voice. And we have come into the fold of the God's kingdom. The fold of his kingdom. Amen. Into his body, his mystical body, the Word. So then man is fighting. Man is fighting for these earthly kingdoms. You see what Russia is trying to do, expand their territory. And all kingdoms seek to do that. That's the nature of man. He has his selfish motives. He has his reasons. And so man has always tried to conquer other peoples, conquer their lands and take over and rule. See, and so we see that's happening. And China wishes it could do it, Russia, and then all these different nations. But, you know, what they're fighting for, it belongs to God's people. See, soon it will... man is fighting for these earthly kingdoms, but they actually belong to God's children that have been redeemed with the earth. The earth is being redeemed. It has to be redeemed. All the earth is groaning. It's groaning to be redeemed, to be freed, to be freed, because it was washed under the flood, the days of Noah. It was sanctified under Jesus at Calvary, at the cross, when the blood dripped from Jesus onto the earth, and it receives its fire baptism, see, as the final stage before the heavenly city comes down and adopts the earth. That's the adoption of the earth. Amen. When the heavenly city of God comes down and plants itself like a cone, right? Because the earth will move up like a giant mountain, a huge mountain, to receive God's city. Isn't that beautiful? Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So then man is fighting what actually belongs to you. It's incredible. You think about that. That's right. The kingdoms will become the kingdoms of Christ and God and the Lord and his children. The saints will inherit the earth. Is that what the Bible says? Oh, yes, that's what the scripture tells us. See, what man is fighting for, well, let him fight. You know, I mean, we know who really is going to fall heir to it. Amen. We know that. Let them fight. They're killing each other, and but it don't belong to them. It belongs to Christ and his children. Jesus Christ is going to rule and reign in the millennium. He'll sit on the throne of David. We'll rule and reign with him. Is that right? We'll rule and reign. So God has redeemed. God is redeeming the earth back to his elect, his people. So now in Isaiah 13 and verse 6, howl ye, for the day of the Lord is at hand. It shall come as a destruction from the Almighty. Therefore shall all hands be faint, and every man's heart shall melt, and they shall be afraid. They shall pangs and sorrows shall take hold of them. They shall be in pain as a woman that travaileth. They shall be amazed one at another. Their faces shall be their faces shall be as flames. Behold, the day of the Lord cometh, cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, to lay the land desolate, and he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it. So then God is going to, he's going to punish the world because it rejected Calvary, because it rejected Jesus Christ and did not want to receive Jesus into their lives as Lord and Savior. So then God here is going to punish the earth under this sixth seal of judgment. It's a judgment seal. Men and women, and they'll throw their gold and silver in the streets during this time. Their wealth and all they've accumulated. It'll mean nothing. It'll mean nothing at all. All the wealth and all their money, it can't buy their soul. It can't buy their soul. So they're going to be in shock at what is happening. I read this and it tells me that men and women are going to be terrorized. They're going to be in shock at what is happening. See? And there's nothing they can do. And it's already too late. It's too late because now is the day of salvation. Now is the hour of repentance. Now is the time to get right with God. Amen. Because it'll be too late then. When this is happening, according to these scriptures, there's nothing they can do because they've sinned their day of grace away. They've sinned it away. The Lamb has left his mercy seat, and there's no more mercy. There's no more compassion. There's no more mercy. It's judgment. The sanctuary is smoking. It's smoking with fire and judgment. And the wrath of God is being poured out upon the earth. The plagues are being poured out upon the earth. And it'd be a horrible time for the stars of heaven. The stars of heaven, verse 10 tells us here in Isaiah, the same thing that that we read over there in Revelations, the sixth chapter. For the stars of heaven and the constellations thereof shall not give their light. The sun shall be darkened in his going forth, and the moon shall not cause her light to shine. So it's a total interruption of nature. Now, remember when Moses delivered Israel out of Egypt. He delivered Israel out of Egypt. Remember that there was darkness throughout Egypt. So the children of God went to Goshen because there's where the light was. So all Egypt was in darkness except the children of God, except the Hebrews, because they were in Goshen and they had light. But there was darkness because God was judging Egypt. God was judging that nation because they didn't want to let Israel go. They didn't want to let God's people go. So God brought judgment, and there was darkness throughout all of Egypt. There was judgment. It was a judgment. And well, because this is what God was doing. What God was doing is that he was delivering his people out of slavery. See, Israel had to come out of Egypt through a mighty hand. God had to display his power. There was an interruption of nature. There was an interruption of nature in Egypt. When God was delivering Israel through Moses, with the rod that God gave him, he smote Egypt time and time again. And the plagues came, and there was darkness, and there was water turning into blood. All kind of plagues and fire and hail. See that? What was God doing? Delivering. God was fixing to deliver Israel out of Egypt with an interruption of nature. You get that? Now, so that is what is, when Jesus was at the Calvary, when he was hanging on the cross, there was darkness throughout the land. There was a great earthquake. During Jesus' crucifixion, there was an interruption of nature. You understand that? There was an interruption of nature. Jesus was hanging on the cross. Here. Let's read it. Let's read it. In Matthew, the 27th chapter, real quickly now, because we're running out of time. Let's read it here in verse 45, verse chapter 27 and verse 45. Let's read it together, okay? We're coming to the end now. Just bear with me. Is everybody all right? Okay, good. That's good. Good. Okay, verse 45. Now from the sixth hour, there was what? Darkness. There was darkness. From the sixth hour, there was darkness over all the land. Now, this is what happened when Moses delivered Israel out of Egypt. Is that right? And now, I'm fixing to try to show you something and then let God reveal it. Let God reveal this to you. But I have to have this background. I have to have this before I come with my conclusion. Okay, now here. From the sixth hour, there was darkness over all the land until the ninth. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, that is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Some of them that stood there, when they heard that, said, this man called for Elias. And straightway one of them ran and took a sponge and filled it with vinegar and put it on a reed and gave him to drink. The rest said, let be, let us see whether Elias will come to save him. Jesus, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom, and the earth did quake. There was an earthquake, and the rocks rent, and the graves were open. You see, earthquakes, resurrection will follow the sixth seal opening. That sixth seal that opens with an earthquake, there will be a resurrection, just like there was in Jesus' time. So when on the West Coast, when the West Coast sinks, then that will cause a resurrection. The saints will start begin to come up, wave after wave, all the way from the West Coast. This is where the gospel ends. It's traveled. The gospel has traveled with the sun. It's traveled from Luther's message to Wesley's message, England, see, and then to the West Coast here. See? And so this is where the gospel ends. So the Pentecostal age here, the Laodicean church age, God has a bride of Pentecostals here that their bodies are laying in the earth, in the ground. See, and wherever they're at, in the seas or wherever God's people are, they're going to come up. The sea can't hold them. The fact that they were eaten up by lions and burned with fire till they become ashes, God's people are going to come up when that voice of the resurrection goes out. That voice of the resurrection goes out, and those seven thunders utter their voices. Seven thunders, seven, that's the voices of God that are going to resurrect the seven church ages. They're going to come forth. Amen. Now, so that's because there's, see, all these things, it's an interruption of nature. Now here's the thing. So then, here's the interruption of nature here, because God's getting, when Jesus was hanging on the cross and he yielded up the ghost, there was a great earthquake, and there was darkness throughout all the land. God was delivering his second son, his greater son, Jesus, from the cross. He yielded up the ghost. He said, it is finished. It is finished, and yielded up the ghost. And all this began to happen, and the centurion said, and the people that were there, they said, surely this must be the Son of God. When they see nature have a bust, a nervous breakdown, God, because God was the creator. Jesus, he was in the world, and the world was created by him. And the world put him on the cross. We put Jesus on the cross because of our sins. He had to go to Calvary. So the earth had its... It had its breakdown, and God was delivering his second son, Jesus, his greater son. And now, see, for the third time, because everything runs in threes. So now, here in the tribulation time, he's delivering the 144,000 out of the book of redemption. See, a book of redemption, meaning that when we're born, all life is precious to God. He puts all life in a book of life. Everything's recorded, and our natural birth is in a book of life. There's another book called the Lamb's Book of Life, and that's your new birth. That's your new life. That's your converted life. Your old life, that's the book of life. That was your old life. All your old deeds are, and your sinful deeds are recorded in that book. Your sinful life, everything that you ever did is recorded in that book of life. And so that's our natural birth. Our nature was to love the world. Our nature was to sin. Our nature was to have pleasure in the world, to lust and to do wicked things. We were sinners. We loved the world. And God don't blame us for that. No. But when he gives us an opportunity to escape that kind of life and we reject it, then there's no hope but judgment. There's nothing left but judgment. God does all he can for us when he gave his son at Calvary to die. And so we have to accept that or perish. Or perish if we don't accept that. Now here in the tribulation time, he's delivering the 144,000 out of the book of redemption. He's because all the names are revealed under the sixth seal. Now I know this is kind of deep. I don't know if you're getting that this is, but are you getting some of it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Amen. Good. So all our names are revealed. Life is recorded under the sixth seal book of redemption. The names were revealed under the sixth. Our names are revealed under the judgment seal. That's why you can look at the Word of God and you can say, yes, I see myself in the Bible. I see I've got to repent. I've got to repent and be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of my sins. So I can be taken out of this sinful book and put over here in the Lamb's book of life, where there's no sin. In the Lamb's book of life, when God transfers your name from the book of life to the Lamb's book of life, see, that's your new book of life. That's your new creation. Amen. That's your Lamb's nature. That's the Lamb's book of life. God give you a Lamb nature. Amen. See, a Lamb nature that's meek, that's humble, that's sweet, that's full of joy and life. And gentleness and kindness. See, all of these holy virtues. It's a Lamb nature. See, now, so God does that. Takes you out of the book of life and puts you in the Lamb's book of life. You understand that? That's important. In other words, your first birth, that's your sexual birth. That's your sexual, natural birth. That's in a book of life. That's in a natural book of life. See, now, that book will face you at the day of judgment, at the white throne judgment, and you'll be judged by your deeds in that book. But see now, but when you come to Jesus and you accept Calvary and you accept Christ into your life and you get the Holy Spirit in your life, then God transfers you into the Lamb's book of life from your natural birth to your spiritual birth. See, because the first man, the Bible says, is earthly. The first man is earthly. The second man is the Lord from heaven. The second man is the Lord. That's powerful, brothers and sisters. What you have in you is the Lord from heaven, the Lord Jesus Christ. That's the second man. Oh, praise his name. You know, so I was thinking of this interruption, because I got to close now. I was thinking of this interruption, and I was thinking, my, that is something. Interrupt, it means to break into something that is continuous or uniform. It means to stop, to interrupt, like like, for example, as we said, the sixth seal is what? Is an interruption of nature. All nature was going in continuity. In continuity, it was all going uniformly. All of a sudden, there's an earthquake. And there's tribulation, and nature is interrupted. All these things are happening. In the great tribulation, the bride has gone up into glory. And I was thinking, thank God, this sixth seal of judgment, and it's a seal of interruption. And we are judged under the sixth seal. That tells me, brothers and sisters, in Christ, that tells me that God had to interrupt us. He had to interrupt. You may have had plans, and you, which is all right. You know, you're in your earthly life. You're born into this world, and you go about your life, and you don't even know. Maybe you don't even realize you're a sinner. But then you heard the word of God. You heard that that the Bible says that we're sinners, and that we need a Savior. We need a Savior because that's what was in God, was to save. We needed a Savior to be saved. Amen. So he saved us. He interrupted our life. He interrupted your life. My life was interrupted. Amen. Thank you for interrupting my life, Lord Jesus. God interrupted your life. Hey, you're going the wrong way. If you keep going that way, you're going to end up in hell fire. You got to go the other way. Come back. Go the other way. Repent means to turn around and go in the opposite direction. Repent. Turn back because you're going the wrong way. So God interrupted you. Aren't you thankful that he interrupted you? That's that sixth seal. You don't know. How this happened, you know, it's mysterious. It's all supernatural. Amen. And we try to explain it the best way that we can. So we can understand God's plan and the revelation, because you have to have this revelation. The revelation of Jesus Christ that God gave to him. And he sent and signified it. By an angel, prophet. The prophet. That was this prophet here, William Branham. This prophet here. So, thank God for that interruption. See? Like, it interrupted our lifestyle. Is that right? You know, you like to go to nightclubs. You like to go to parties. You like to drink. You like to smoke. You were addicted to all these things. We were all that way because we're sinners. Maybe we weren't committing the same sins, but we were still sinning because we're born in sin, shaped in iniquity, come into the world speaking lies. And we've all gone astray, and there's none good amongst us. We all need a Savior. So then we were going on with our lives, loving life, but one day we heard the gospel. One day you heard the gospel of your salvation, and we were apprehended by it. Now, that's a powerful word, apprehended. That's in the Bible. The gospel apprehended you. It seized you. It interrupted you. Interrupted you. It arrested you. Amen. Amen. It arrested you. And it made you a prisoner of him. We're prisoners of Jesus Christ. So it interrupted our lifestyle. The gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ interrupted our sinner's life and called us to repentance. You couldn't live the same way anymore. Our love for the world and the things of the world, it died out. We're dead to it. The word of God was changing us. The judgment of God's word interrupted your book of life, your natural life, your natural birth. It interrupted your natural birth to give you a Holy Ghost birth. That's why we groan. We groan, according to Romans 8, to be delivered. Our bodies are groaning because we've been given a new birth of the word. And we had to have an interruption of our lives so we could listen to that still small voice of God's word that was revealing itself to us. God reveals himself to you because you are his bride, his wife. He reveals his secrets to his wife. Is that right? The wife gets the secrets. So God had to interrupt our first nature to give us a new nature, the nature of a lamb. And that's why we see all these crossing of planets and the stars and the blackouts and the eclipses and streaks of fire going across the skies and different events, different things happening, which the world really don't know what's going on. They recognize it, they see it, they speak about it, they put it in the news and so forth, but we know what it means because Peter said in the last days there'd be signs in the heavens, signs in the skies, pillars of smoke and fire, see, and vapors of smoke, and there would be all these signs, earthquakes and divers places and the sea roaring waves of hurricanes and tornadoes and all these judgments. What does it mean? It's a sign that God is going to deliver his church, his bride, to take her into a rapture. Amen. And that's what I want to get over to you. God bless you. Amen. Amen. Was that good or not? God bless you. Josiah.
Amen. How many are excited tonight? How many are happy to be in his wing? Amen. 252 Kiev F in the great triumphant morning. Amen. We have so much to look forward to, church. Amen. 252 in our hymnal. Amen. In the great triumphant morning, when we hear the bridegroom cry, and the dead in Christ shall rise, oh, we'll be changed to life immortal in the twinkling of an eye, and meet Jesus in the skies. We shall all rise to meet him, we shall all go to greet him in the morning when the dead in Christ shall rise. Oh, we shall all rise to meet him. We shall all go to greet him and shall have the marriage supper in the skies. And in the great triumphant morning, what a happy time 'twill be when the dead in Christ shall rise. Oh, when the Lord descends in glory, sets his waiting children free, and we meet him in the skies. We shall all rise to meet him, we shall all go to greet him in the morning when the dead in Christ shall rise. And we shall all rise to meet him, we shall all go to greet him, and we'll have the marriage supper in the skies. And in the great triumphant morning, when the harvest is complete, dead in Christ shall rise, and we'll be crowned with life immortal. Christ and all the loved ones meet, and meet rapture in the skies. Oh, we shall all rise to meet him, we shall all. Morning when the dead in Christ shall rise. We shall all rise to meet him, we shall all go supper in the skies. And in the great triumphant morning, all the kingdoms will possess. Then the dead in Christ shall rise. Oh, reign as kings and priests eternal, under Christ forever blessed. After meeting in the skies, oh, we shall all rise to meet him. We shall all go to greet him in the morning when the dead in Christ shall rise. We shall all rise to meet him. We shall all go to greet him, and we'll have the marriage supper in the skies. Praise him and praise him. Oh, praise him and praise him in the morning and praise him in the noontime. Praise him. Oh, praise him and praise him when the sun goes down. And love him, oh, love him, and love him in the morning, and love him in the noontime. Love him, oh, love him, and love him when the sun goes down. Serve him, and serve him, oh, serve him in the morning, serve him in the noontime, serve him, and serve him when the sun goes down. You've got to keep walking, you've got to keep walking, keep right on walking. Keep walking in the light of the Lord. You'll get to heaven someday. Oh, if you walk the right way. Keep walking in the light of the Lord. You've got to keep walking. Keep right on walking. Keep walking in the light of the Lord. You'll get to heaven someday. Oh, if you walk the right way. Keep walking in the light of the Lord.
Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. And Jesus, I'll never forget how you said me free. And Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Let's stand. Jesus, I'll never forget. No, never. Amen. Jesus on the inside, working on the outside. Oh, what a change in my life. Amen. What a change. What an interruption. What an interruption. I love it. I love that. Thank you, Jesus, for interrupting my life. Can you say that? Say that. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for interrupting my life. Amen. For interrupting my life. Amen. Because Jesus, you saved me from myself. Oh, my own selfish self, you saved me. Redeem me and fill me with the Holy Ghost and set me free. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to let you go. We're going to pray. If you would like to be prayed for, you remain in the auditorium. If you'd like to be prayed for, we want to pray for you. We want some elders here in the church, all the elders to remain in the church. And the rest of you folks, I know you have to go. It's Wednesday and it's midweek, and some of you have your children go to school or whatever, go to work, and so we're going to let you go. But if you need prayer, for whatever reason, you stay in the auditorium. And myself and the elders of the church will anoint you with oil and believe God for you, whatever your need is. Okay? Is that understood? All right. Amen. Let's bow our heads. Thank you, Jesus, for this opportunity, Lord, to come to your house, Lord, to break the bread of life to your children. Lord, to hear these things, Lord, what you're doing in this hour, preparing a bride, getting her dressed, Lord, for the wedding supper, getting us prepared, getting us all dressed and so we can have the Holy Ghost, Lord, the wedding garment on, Father, for that great day when the church is going to be raptured, because you're going to come for a church that's in expectation, that's groaning in the spirit, that's in travail, wanting to be delivered from the bondage of corruption. Lord, each one of your children that are here and those that are viewing the service online, Lord, bless them, Lord, as I speak. Bless their lives, heal them, help them in their afflictions, in their trials, in their distress. Lord, be with them, comfort them by the Holy Ghost. We ask it all in the precious name of Jesus Christ, and God's people said, amen. You are dismissed. Those of you that have to go, if you need prayer, you come right up. We have the oil here. We're going to pray for you, whatever that deed is. Amen. We believe God is here. Amen. He said, ask what you will, and it shall be done. If you abide in me and I abide in you, it shall be done. Anybody else that would like to be prayed for? Some of the elders, please, brothers. Brother Raul, please. Amen. If you're an elder, come. Help. We're all part of this body of Jesus Christ. I want to be identified with the body and the works of Jesus. Amen. We want to pray for our sister, and we want to pray for anyone that needs prayer. Amen. You that have remained behind, we're going to all pray together and believe God for our sister Selena right now. She's going through a battle. She's going through a trial. And you know, the Bible says that the stronger ones should intercede for the weaker ones. The stronger ones should pray for the weaker ones and stand with them. Stand with them. Our dear sister has been serving the Lord many, many years, and she has suffered afflictions. She's suffered different trials and different things that have occurred in her life. But Jesus loves her, and Jesus is here for her, and he's mindful of her. He cares for her, and he's going to help her right now through our prayers and through our faith in the name of Jesus Christ. Brother Stephen, I want you to pray also with us, Brother Fred, Brother Raul, Brother Ralph, and the family back here. I want you to pray also. She's related to you, isn't she? Selena is related to you. Yes, so we're going to pray right now that God will help her. And let her know you don't stand alone, Sister Selena. You don't stand alone. You have a spiritual family, and you have a natural family. You have all these people that love you here. All these relatives that love you, that care for you, care for your amen. Lord Jesus, we come in the name of Jesus. I anoint her with oil. Brother Ralph, touch her, heal her. Amen. Touch her, pray for her right now in the name of Jesus. We stand with you, Sister Selena. You're going to overcome. Amen. We battle against the enemy right now. We come against the enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. Satan, you're defeated. You're defeated, Satan. By the word of God defeats you. The word of God defeats you. Amen. The word of God, amen, defeats you, Satan. Amen. Yes, the word of God. We bind every power of the enemy right now. We rebuke you, Satan. Amen. Amen. Let my sister have the joy of her salvation. Let her. We drive away the depression. We rebuke you, spirit of depression. We rebuke you, spirit of depression and negativity. We rebuke those spirits. They're spirits from hell. Satan, we come against you by the authority of the church of the living God. In the name of Jesus Christ, Sister Selena, amen. Be set free in Jesus' name. Raise your hands right now in Jesus. Yes, thank you. It's coming. It's on its way. There it is. In Jesus' name. Yes, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Yes, Selena. Claim it. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. We need him. We need our Jesus. We need him. He's here. He's a very present help in the time of trouble. In Jesus Christ's name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We bind you. He's defeated, Sister Selena. Satan. You don't have to be depressed. You don't have to be sad.
Amen.
You're a daughter of God. You have eternal life.
That's right. Amen.
You should be happy. Show that devil that you can smile. Let me see a smile.
Amen. There we go.
There you go. Amen. That's that girl. That a girl. Yes, that's the way to do it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Turn around to your family. Turn around and say, thank you, Lord. Look at your, look at your loved one. Amen. Look at her. Amen. Little children here. God bless you.
Yes.
My.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. We thank you, Father, for deliverance. We thank you for deliverance, delivering our dear sister. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Isn't she wonderful? Look at her. Look at your loved one.
Amen.
Look at her. Smile.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Look at her, honey. Look at that.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Yes, sister.
This is my granddaughter.
This is your granddaughter. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Sure. Sure.
Amen.
What is her name?
Her name.
Penelope. Hey. Is it okay if we anoint you with oil? Can we anoint you with oil? Is that okay? How old is she? Four, okay. Maybe five? Yes. Anoint her sticking with oil. And so, what kind of a blessing do you want?
Exactly. Is it something to do?
Trauma. Right. I understand. I can read between the lines. Okay. Let's pray for right now, Brother Ralph. Let's pray.
Heavenly Father.
Sister Selena, you pray too. Amen. Everybody pray. Thank you, Jesus.
For our little sister Penelope.
Yes. Yes, Jesus.
Deliver her,
Lord. From that trauma. From her past, Lord. Lord, from her past, that the enemy has done these things, Lord. And her emotions have been hurt, Lord. Her feelings, Lord. Her past, Lord. We come now in the name of Jesus Christ. Rebuke the enemy. Lord, Satan, you come out of my dear sister. You have no right to torment her. She's free. She's a child. You said, let the children come unto me, for theirs is the kingdom. Yes, Lord Jesus. Father, we rebuke you, Satan. Set God's little child free. She has a little angel. She has an angel that accompanies her. It's been watching over her. It's been with her, helping her. Amen. There's God's presence. May the Holy Ghost, the dove, rest upon her. Lord, may the anointing of God rest upon her right now. Lord, in Jesus Christ's name, may healing come. Lord, to her mind, Lord. May healing come in the name of Jesus Christ. May the past be stricken off. Off her past. May it be stricken off the book of life, Lord. Amen. In Jesus' name, she is God's beloved child. Amen. She's a little daughter of God, a little child of God. And we claim her for the kingdom of God. We claim her for Jesus Christ. In Jesus Christ's name, we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. God bless you, honey. In Jesus' name, bless you, honey. You love Jesus? You love him? Oh, that's wonderful. Jesus loves you too. Very much. Very much Jesus loves you. God bless you, honey. God bless you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I'd like to take a picture of this. It's so nice. Wonderful. Thank you, Jesus. This, yes. This is different. Yes.
I just want to get closer. And not tell them certain things that the devil's trying to keep me. I want to
to help you. Selena, you're going to pray too for Sister Stephanie. You're going to pray for her, okay? Just what God did for you. Amen. God can do for our sister. She needs help. She needs the Lord's help. I want you to pray for her and keep praying always, okay? In the name of Jesus Christ, we come, Father. We rebuke the kingdoms of Satan. We rebuke hell and all its forces. We rebuke you, Satan. You demons that would try to make my dear sister's life miserable. You would try to get her to look at her old book of life and bring up these things from her old past. We rebuke that. That book is forgotten. It's closed and thrown in the sea of forgetfulness, Lord. And it's not real. It's just false. It's false data, false reports, Lord. But it's the Lamb's book of life. My sister has entered into that Lamb's book of life. She wants the nature of a lamb. She wants the nature of the lamb and the nature so the dove can rest with her. The dove can come to her helper, Lord, in her trials. Help her. Lord, give her patience, Lord, and help her with her temper, Lord. God, Father, may she suffer. May she suffer whatever persecution, Lord, she has to go through. Lord, because what we suffer here is not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in her. Lord, you're fixing to reveal your glory in her. Lord Jesus, Father, God, we come in the name of Jesus Christ. And we claim victory for my sister in Jesus Christ's name. And we tear Satan's kingdom down in the name of Jesus Christ. We tear his kingdom down. And may the Holy Spirit dove rest with my dear sister. Give her peace. Lord, give her peace, Lord Jesus. And joy, Lord, and rest in the Holy Ghost. Lord Jesus, Father, take away all that old goaty nature in Jesus' name, Lord. Give her the lamb nature of the Holy Spirit. Grant it, Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you. Amen. You're going to be all right, sister. Everything is all right.
Yes, amen.
Under Jesus. Thank you, yes. Claim it now in Jesus' name. Claim it. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank Hallelujah. Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank Just believe it, receive it. It's yours in Jesus' name. It's done.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
It's done. Finish. Believe it.
Oh,
believe it.
Amen.
Amen. Don't let the devil come against you anymore. He's defeated.
Amen.
He's defeated
That's
by the word
right.
of God. Hallelujah. Yes.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. The enemy is defeated. The enemy is defeated. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah, you have your family. You all are together. You have each other.
My mom, my family.
Yes, hallelujah. You're not alone.
Yes, glory to God.
You have a lot to do.
Yes. Yes, yes, Jesus. Thank you. Mercy rewrote my life. Anybody else need prayer?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Sister. Brother Raul. Amen. Man. Brother Ralph, you will lead us in prayer in this here. And I want her to be anointed with this oil. You could anoint her with oil and lead the prayer. Amen for us. And I want to anoint her also with oil. Brother
Thank
Fred,
you.
Brother Raul. Ooh, sorry, Brother Fred. Okay. Sorry about that. Yeah, that's good. The more the better. Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Father. Thank
yes.
you, Lord. Anoint her with oil, as the Bible yes. says. Yes. Yes. Brother Ralph, amen. Let us
Lord.
Pray. Thank you, Jesus. Sister Selena, amen. Let's pray.
God. They've
yes.
been sincere
yes.
and they've
yes.
been honest and they've
yes.
opened their hearts, dear God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Of their life. Lord, we were sitting back there and watching them, dear God. Lord, they entered into the service. They heard the word. God, something has taken
yes.
place this evening. Lord, they made it known to the fire of the heart, petition. Child, hear this thing.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
He is asking, dear God, for this one here, this little child.
Yes, Lord.
God, she needs deliverance. She needs
wisdom. Yes, she needs deliverance. Yes. Yes, Father. Hallelujah. Yes, in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus Christ, bring them together as a family.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I pray that the revelation of Jesus Christ, yes, the Word of God, of what it means to serve God.
Yes, amen.
What it means to come in contact with Almighty God.
Yes,
what
hallelujah.
What it means to be a part of who God is, the economy
yes,
is. May God, you reveal that to this family,
yes,
dear God.
Lord.
It's not, dear God, just words, but it's life.
Yes, Lord.
It's your power of your Holy Ghost, yes, that transforms our lives.
Yes, yes, Jesus.
Lord, we are testimonies, God,
yes,
of who you are. And
yes,
done.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
And Father, we're praying for this family, God. She made her heart known to you this day.
Yes.
Sincere, dear God. I pray, we pray together as a body in Jesus Christ's name. Father, may you take, Lord, this child. And God, may the atmosphere be created in this home.
Yes.
May you turn their lives, dear God, from where they once were.
Yes.
And turn them to, Lord, to you.
Yes.
God, we pray that God's salvation will come into their hearts. And God,
yes,
will come to know you in a way like never before.
Yes, yes, hallelujah.
God, we
thank
pray
you,
and honestly, sincerely, as a family of God,
yes, Lord,
we bring them before
yes,
you now, Lord Jesus.
Yes, we do.
And we ask you, Father, and know that it'll be done.
Yes, Father.
We believe it, God. And we
yes,
now
Lord,
ask you to confirm it.
Yes, Lord.
Restore this family, God. Just restore their hearts.
Yes, yes, in Jesus' name.
And
amen.
God,
we claim
yes,
it.
Father.
Claim
we
it.
Claim them, God.
Yes, we do,
Jesus'
Lord,
name.
And Lord, we want to see them as testimonies, testifying of what
yes,
God has done.
For the glory of God, yes.
Father, may they come to know you now
yes,
in a greater measure.
Yes, Lord.
And for this little child, dear God.
Yes, Lord.
The blood of Jesus Christ
yes,
covers her life.
Yes, Father.
And God, we are continue
yes,
in prayer for her in Jesus
yes,
Christ's name.
Yes.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Yes. I just want to say, stay together as a family members. Keep in touch with one another. And share the word of God with each other and pray for one another. Okay, remember, Selena, you're not alone.
Amen.
None of you are alone.
Amen.
You have the Lord Jesus Christ above all. Above everything, you have the Lord Jesus, and you have each other.
Amen.
And you
Amen,
have these children.
Yes.
God has placed them into your hands. And God's going to help
yes,
raise them.
Amen.
God's going to help you.
Thank
give you.
You
the wisdom to raise them properly.
Yes.
Yes. You need
yes,
prayer.
Yes.
Okay.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Sure, did you hear all that? You lead the prayer. I want to anoint her, too, with oil. I want to anoint her. This oil symbolizes the Holy Spirit, the dove. Dove of the Holy Spirit. We anoint you with the Holy Spirit, sister. God bless you. Amen. I'm going to pray. Ralph, did you get some of this? Did you with the oil? God symbolizing the dove. Holy Spirit coming upon your life. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we just come
you,
to your
Jesus,
throne of mercy tonight.
Yes,
Lord.
God.
Our sister had poured out her heart, Father.
Yes.
She has many requests this evening. Lord.
Yes, Lord God. Hallelujah.
Lord God, give her the peace, Father,
yes,
that surpasses all understanding,
yes,
Father.
Yes.
Touch her heart
yes,
this
yes,
evening, Lord.
Yes.
Touch her mind, Father.
Yes.
Build her faith,
yes,
Lord.
Yes, Jesus.
Lord, she needs her faith to be increased, Father.
Yes.
God, give her understanding
yes,
tonight.
Yes,
Lord.
Father, yes.
Strengthen her mind,
yes,
her heart, Father.
Yes.
Let her life be a life that lives this gospel so her family can see
yes,
this
yes,
life.
Amen, yes.
So she can bring salvation
yes,
to her family
oh,
with
hallelujah,
a life that
thank
she
you,
lives,
Jesus,
Heavenly Father.
Amen.
God, we ask that tonight, Father, may she stay with her family that is in this house. May they work together. Lord, Father, nothing more powerful when a family comes together and works towards the kingdom of God. Lord, we ask, Father,
thank
that you,
Jesus,
strengthen her tonight. Strengthen her children, Father, that are in this house. Her grandchildren, Father.
Yes,
everything that she
yes,
loves, Father.
Yes, Father.
Bless it tonight,
yes,
Lord. And may she leave this building knowing, Father, that you are with her.
Yes, Lord.
God, bless her.
Yes,
bless her family.
Father, yes.
Bless all those who she talks to.
Yes. Amen.
We
Hallelujah.
Ask this all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. May she believe what has been said tonight.
Yes, Father.
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Receive your healing tonight.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Believe what you ask for, and God will. Jesus.
And you're a beautiful people, beautiful family. God bless you. Trust in Jesus. Everybody fine? You're okay? Everything's fine? Okay. Trust in Jesus is all that really matters. Your life will never be the same. Trust in Jesus is all that really matters. That really matters. And your life will never be the same. For there's only
one way to really touch him. Oh, just believe when you call on his name.
Touching Jesus.
Oh, touching Jesus is all that really matters, and your life will never be the same. Oh, there's only one way to really touch him. Oh, just believe when you call on his name.
He said every need.
He said every need supplied. There is healing, cleansing, sweet peace inside. He said every need is supplied.
If I had to name.
And if I had to name the greatest blessing he's given, how would I decide? For after he saved me, I just have to say that my every need is supplied.
Every need.
He said every need supplied. He said every need, oh, supplied. There is healing, cleansing,
inside. He said every need supplied.